opportunity this morning and this afternoon, as our colleague here just said, to be able to share and learn from each other. And we started off this dialogue by really thinking about, given the escalating risk and vulnerability that globally we face, and especially on this continent, how can we do things differently? And in a way, what sort of evidence and knowledge is out there that perhaps could support you, the policymakers, to become more effective and perhaps to use finite resources more appropriately? And from what I gathered from the presentation, and I think you all did as well, is that you're all faced with many, many challenges. And there are just a whole host of potential solutions out there. So we heard from Uganda that they have 5 strategic areas, looking at agriculture, looking at infrastructure, ITC. We heard in Ethiopia a little bit about the environment and the need here to have green agriculture, right? We heard as well issues in West Africa, especially thinking about spontaneous settlements and how to deal with slums and urbanization issues. In South Africa, we heard about issues around social cohesion and how more appropriately to deliver that package. So what I gather from this is, again, here, though there are many challenges, there's a desire and a need to prioritize, right? We have to use those finite resources in a way that it becomes targeted. But how do we do that? How do we actually support you to be able to develop the appropriate national policies that can be impactful at the household level? I mean, that's the real challenge here, is that if we develop national policies, is it reflective at that household community level? And if it's not, how do you evaluate, how do you adapt your policies in a way where ultimately it has that impact? So at the RAND, we have, over the last 4.5 years, attempted to develop an integrated strategy that perhaps elevates the voices of the communities to prioritize their challenges, to identify the existing capacity, to provide some measurement that, and evidence that perhaps can guide solutions based upon that evidence, to implement deliberative polling to help, again, in terms of having informed decision making at that community level to inform policies. So we're going to spend the next 30 to 45 minutes to provide you with an overview of how we go about resilience measurement, how we have developed that enabling environment to take that knowledge and develop solutions, and how deliberative polling has been effectively implemented to guide policymakers in Africa. So I'll start off again with the issues at hand, right? Over the last 30 years, the amount of disasters, floods, earthquakes, landslides, have increased globally. The United Nations says that 5 times more people today are affected by disasters than a generation ago. That's our reality. And even though we've seen that there have been trends of more resources flowing to deal with famine and relief efforts, we're still faced with the daunting task that these risks and these disasters continue to escalate.